It is the fourth day of the flood havoc in Karnataka. While many homes and schools are ravished by the floods, the latest to be flooded is the famous Saundatti Yellamma temple in Belagavi. Rising water levels have submerged the temple completely. Several of the devotees had to come to the temple and they were left in lurch. Let me go across to my colleague Neha Hebbale, who's joining us live with those details there. Neha, this is a famous temple. We're given to understand this is the Saundatti Yellamma temple in Belagavi, one of those districts which have been worst affected. Can you take us through the details of the kind of steps that have been taken and how these devotees have now been taken to safety?
Well, absolutely. You know, of course, what we're given to understand is that, you know, this temple was, in fact, one of the most frequently visited, one of the most popular temples, not only in Karnataka, but in fact, it would witness tourists from across the country and Maharashtra also, especially, you know, coming down to this temple to pray, to offer their prayers. Now, it is most unfortunate, you know, while we're talking about devastation across the state of Karnataka, this temple has also been submerged under the water. Thankfully, you know, of course, the devotees were not really allowed till the premises of the temple. And even in fact, you know, from a distance itself, that's what we're given to understand, that, you know, they've stood at a distance and offered their prayers. But really, you know, this is just one of the other such structures that has been submerged underwater and that has been affected by the rains this time around.
So unprecedented situation there. The devotees in the temple were left in the lurch, as you're pointing out. This is, of course, day four of the flood havoc that we're witnessing in the state of Karnataka. Neha, request you to stay with us at this point because we're also getting more inputs of the kind of devastation and the manner in which the floods have wreaked havoc across Karnataka. Remember, it is the second time in just 2 months that Karnataka is ravished by floods. Heavy rains lashed the state for the last 3 days and the situation continues to remain grim. It may even turn worse, as the IMD have predicted heavy to very heavy rainfall in the coastal and the interior areas of Karnataka. Data shows that just 2 days of rain has destroyed 5,500 homes. Five people have died in rain-related incidents in the state. Over 2,000 people have been shifted to relief camps.